Hi, and welcome to this demonstration of how to manually add a camera using Aimetis Symphony 7. First, we must log into the web-based administrator client. Once we log in, we are taken to the cameras list under the devices section, as you can see here. What we want to do here is click on Add Cameras at the top. It's important to note that at the bottom of the screen, you will see that in this example, the administrator has 12 Symphony licenses remaining to apply to cameras. For each camera you add to your network, a license will be used. Instead of picking Begin Automatic Discovery, click the Add Camera Manually button next to it. In here, you must start by providing the IP address of the camera you are trying to connect. Then select the camera manufacturer from the drop-down menu. In this particular case, we are adding an Axis camera. Next, provide the username and password used to connect to the camera, and then click Connect. Once Symphony has connected with the camera, it will be added to the camera list here at the bottom. The camera is automatically checked, and as you can see at the bottom, one of the licenses has been removed with 11 remaining. By clicking Next, you can see more details of the camera, including the ability to apply a new name to the camera, a template to the camera, and add it into a group. In this particular case, I'm going to place it in the indoor group of the devices tree, and then add the indoor people tracking analytic to it. Finally, click Add One Selected Camera. Because we are adding one camera manually, we are brought directly to the configuration page. Now, once this camera has been added, I'm going to continue the configuration of this camera so it can be usable with the operator client. If I scroll down, you will see a dedicated video section. Within this section, you have the ability to control the video quality and video streams of the camera. In this example, the camera resolution is cranked up high, but it can be easily adjusted to fit your needs. The frames per second can also be adjusted along with the video codecs to define the quality of the video you wish to have from the video stream coming in. Because it is often important to record video on a schedule or on motion, you have the ability right here by adjusting the recording mode. In this example, I'm going to adjust the setting to record on pixel changes detected by PC. And I'm going to put it on a previously created schedule of 24/7. By scrolling down to the add-on section, I'm going to enable motion detection, and to the right, click on the configure button. On this page, you have the ability to define the pixel changes
and how sensitive the analytic is to simple motion detection in order to trigger video recording that was just configured.
If you scroll down to motion detection, you can define the area of interest. Make sure you select ignore, and as you can see here, I am using the sample frame that's provided here to ignore the area around the camera because no motion will be detected in those areas. You can easily increase or decrease the size of the shading brush to ensure higher accuracy. If you make a mistake, you simply return to the top, click Analyze, and fill in the needed areas of the camera. Once you feel you have the area covered, scroll down to Grid View to adjust sensitivity of the motion detection video analytic. By dragging the grid spacing slider side to side, you can define the granularity you like in order to detect motion. Once you've made the desired adjustments, click OK. The software is now updating, applying the changes to that camera. Now we continue to scroll down, looking at additional configuration settings. For example, you can see which groups the camera has been added to in the device tree. Storage paths can also be defined here, along with setting video storage limits. By finally clicking Save, all the configuration changes will be applied to the camera. The camera will now record on motion through monitoring pixel change, allowing you to save on hardware space and bandwidth in your VMS software, as well as providing recording of events when they occur. Thank you for watching this video on how to manually add and configure a camera to record on motion using Aimetis Symphony 7.